All right, everybody. Glad to have you on board. We'll get a couple little formalities knocked out. You guys got a beautiful flight coming up, so it's gorgeous out there. There's a lot of extra waterfalls. So I'm sure inside they told you my name, so it's Brian. Easy to remember flying Brian. You forget that, hey, you's just as good as my name. So I'm very informal. I like to joke around. I already tell you guys are laid back, easy going, so we'll have a good trip. We'll knock out these formalities, get you guys rolling. By a show of thumbs, did everybody receive the safety briefing while you're inside? Everybody got that? Any questions at all? Everybody's good? Okay. And then, Miss Maegan, you got the orange handle on the door over there. Just make sure not to accidentally bump it or pull it. If I need to pull it, I'll put you to work on your holiday. I'll put you in for a big raise, okay? So we'll try to skip all that, right?
All right, Maegan, Cheryl, look back here.
I will finish up these formalities real quick. And guys, as we take off, I will need to turn the microphones off on takeoff and then also approach into the airport by FAA regulations. But during the flight, feel free to use those, talk to each other, take pictures, whatever you like. We'll give you a heads up, let you know a lot of voices in my head. I think they're real. They seem nice mostly, and so, there are a lot of voices in my head. I promise that part's true. But there's a lot of other helicopters out flying around. That's where I hear all those at the same time I'm talking to you guys. So safety before the tour for me, obviously. And so if I ask you to hang on or miss a question, turn the mics off. Don't ever take that personal. Just give me a minute to ask again. I just didn't hear you. I'm dealing with those guys at the same time we're talking. So other than that, if you guys are excited, ready to go, we'll turn the mics off, start rolling. Sound good? All right, give me just a second. Once I get our clearance out of here, I will give you guys a heads up before we leave. Let's go fly. See the world in green and blue. See China right in front of you. See the canyons broken by cloud. See the tuna fleets clearing the sea out. See the bedlam fires. Still have the mics turned off for just a few more minutes, but as soon as the tower releases me legally, I can turn those on. Everybody doing okay so far? Everybody's good? Yeah. As you got in the Willy Willy Harbor coming up in front of us, and then you got your cruise ship over here on the right. Unfortunately, I can't make any turns. We're in between two runways. They don't let us do any turns here, but John, I'll make sure to get that on the video as well. But if you guys on the right side happen to get a good picture, I'm sure John and Benny would appreciate if you'd share one if you get a chance. Benny, you got one of our lighthouses coming up here on the left. There's only two on the island. That one, you need a four-wheel drive to get out to, or have a really dislike for your rental car. I do see them out there, but I can't imagine how they get them out there. And the Willy Willy Harbor, where you guys are docked at, this is pretty much the lifeline for us here in Kauai. So just about all of our supplies, of course, comes in by ship. You guys like movie history? Like hearing about stuff like that? Yeah. A lot of cool stuff around the island, so I'll put that in the tour. First one is this river right here. You guys, it's called the Hula'ia River. Everybody remembers Indiana Jones, right? And so you remember the scene in Indiana Jones where he comes out of the jungle, jumps in the water, and he swims out to the sea, like, take all had all the snakes on board? That was mostly filmed right up here on this part of the river. I remember seeing that when I was younger, thinking that's pretty neat. Not the snakes, I don't like those, but no snakes in Hawaii, so we're good. So I guess I'll remain. this ridge line we're flying alongside. This is called the Haupu Ridge. I bet every one of you has seen it 50 times and you don't realize it. If you ever saw the TV show MASH, you've seen this. And so as soon as MASH comes on, the helicopters take off and land. And right in the background is the hill. This is that same hill. And then just on the other side of it, it's called Kipukai. It's private land owned by one family. But as we go past this low gap, take a look over that way. If you ever saw the movie The Descendants with George Clooney, you'll probably recognize that little piece of land right there. So that was the family piece of land. You get that same view in the movie. This ranch below us is a Rice family ranch. And it's a working cattle ranch, but it's also made a couple appearances in some of the Jurassic Park series. All right, everybody, just got released from the tower, so the microphones are on. Feel free to use those, talk to each other, ask questions, sing some karaoke, whatever you like. Everybody's doing okay?
Yeah.
Doing good.
What about driving around? Did anybody get a do one of the tours yesterday or get a chance to get out and drive around? A little bit, yeah. You guys go up to the canyon? Waimea Canyon? Nope, didn't go that way. What about a little seal? Did anybody get a chance to see one of our seals on the beach? No. They're pretty rare. There's Poipu over here on the left, and sometimes some of the tours will take you over there. There's one beach that they'll come up and sleep on, pretty common, but they're really rare. There's only 1,400. They're called a Hawaiian monk seal. They're one of only two native mammals that we have here in Hawaii. The other one's a little bat found all throughout North America, so for whatever reason, they come up on that beach just about every day. And right now we've only had 47, two little pups were just born in the last month, so 47 right now. They're still doing okay. But how about tree tunnels? Did anybody get a chance to drive through tree tunnels? You go back on YouTube, you check it out. It doesn't look like a lot when we fly over it. It's just on the other side of this ridge right here. I'll point it out. But you get back on the ship, you know, and pull that up and look at it. And this is it right here. And you probably, if you still have a rental car, you still have time to drive through that before you guys leave. But it is beautiful when you drive through that. A novelist died. I have asked, though, Benny. They won't let us fly through it. They ruled that out pretty quick, yeah. I got a bartender here. Get that little wind bump right there. We'll get a few more of those as we come into the mountains up here. Not a big deal, guys. I will not take any chances whatsoever. So the helicopter handles it really well. It just kind of goes up and down, wiggles back and forth a little bit like you feel. What about the family here in Kauai that has 51,000 acres? Have you heard about those guys? No. One family, 51,000 acres. So this is all their land right here. The Robinsons, and right now two brothers have it. It's been set up in a trust fund, so it gets handed down generation after generation. So it's Bruce and Keith Robinson have this right now. Those two guys are my uncles. What? I wish. That'd be nice, right? I'd be so happy with 1 acre here, much less 51,000 of them. I kind of talk off and on about those guys, but everybody's familiar with the Jurassic Park movies? You guys have all seen those? How about the new one? Have you seen it? Not yet. It's a good movie. Not much. Most of it's in Oahu and Maui. A little bit of Kauai. They used our helicopter for about 3 days here, but not much of it made it into the movie. Guys, right through here is where we're going to get some of those wind bumps. So don't let those surprise you again. Not a big deal. They just always get them through here the way the winds blow over the islands. There they are. Mother Nature blowing you a kiss, saying aloha. Welcome to Kauai. So the
odd place for a billboard back there.
That was actually put up by the military. It was an old radar. They bounced radar off that, supposedly. It was bright and white, John, so they the locals, after they quit using it, complained about it. And the government, instead of taking it down, paints it green and puts that zigzag on top of it, make it blend in. So this first valley we're coming up to is called Hanapepe Valley. You follow it down to the ocean, you can see the bay down there. That's Port Allen. And so most of our smaller boat trips, day cruises, come in and out of Port Allen. And all the dark green fields, those are the coffee fields. We have the largest coffee plantation in the United States here in Kauai. couple of overlooks if anybody went around that way that you may have pulled over.